No, 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 no. No, no. No! Speak again, no! It's DJ Sharp, no! When you see DJ Sharp, no, it's death itself! Well, actually, no. In this case, the Grim Reaper is gonna have to hang up this scythe because I pass it. Yes! 191 BPM, out of my comfort zone. Trying to push my limits to improve at higher speeds. Let's begin the commentary. This beginning portion, pretty simple, straightforward, eighth notes. Look at this roll here, just alternate your foot between the roll and the other regular notes. So one foot stays on the roll, and then the other foot hits the other notes. Got it? Good. And there's these little bursts of 16ths during this opening segment here like that. It's not that big of a deal until it gets into the full speed, and now there's gonna be basically no breaks until the end. Good luck! but don't worry, it's possible. Just fend off the Grim Reaper as well as the arrows, and victory will be yours. As usual, keep your feet relaxed, keep your legs relaxed for maximum speed and stamina conservation. And I found that this was a really, really good way to do it, this particular song here, because there's so much of it that as the tiredness started to kind of come on me, I started to get a feel for what I should be doing, so to speak, instead, you know, to keep moving rather than using excess energy at this speed. So I found this to be a fantastic learning experience as I went. Like, you can tell I'm not too tired right now, but I start to waver near the end, but then I recover when I change my technique a little bit. Like, the way that I am using my legs, or my muscles, I should say, it's not really that apparent in the video, but just try and pay attention to it, and you'll be able to see quite a difference at that point when I shift over at the end. So yeah, as I was saying, there's no breaks here. It's, you know, it's under 5 minutes, but that is not a break. It only looks like there's a little dip in the graph there, but it's such a short dip that it doesn't really make much of a difference. So it feels mostly like these are all joined in one. And I've been saying that a lot about the 17s I've been playing lately, and I guess that's what makes them a 17. And because, yeah, it's just unrelenting if it's short or if it's long. Although the longer ones tend to be at a lower BPM, but you know, it's still just as dense in the streams in a way. So that's what makes it a 17. You know, it's really, really taxing no matter what the speed you're playing it as, because lower speed, it's still gonna wear you down because there's more of those streams. Higher speed, there may be less streams, but it's faster. So adjust your technique accordingly for the most longevity. Now, you can tell by my posture that I'm getting a little bit worn here, especially with that little dip that you've seen in the graph there. And you're about to see another dip in the graph coming soon enough. Yeah, it's... Yeah, calm down, PKM. Relax, relax. See, now, did you notice I just changed what I was doing there to get myself back on track? Like, my technique and everything like that? It's not that apparent. It's just that I'm not... I guess you could say as wild with my body, if that makes sense. And that's what I need to do all the time, not just when I'm really tired. You know, I gotta have that technique when I am trying even harder stuff so that I can conserve as much energy as possible throughout. But, you know, it's just a thing of that I need to get it down to reflex. And I think that's what we can all learn from rhythm games, is that the more you play it, the more you get out of your comfort zone, the more the reflexes take over.
Not bad. Aside from that hiccup that I had, I was like, oh, no. You know, that dip right there near the end? Yeah, I kind of flopped on that part, but... Whew. Yeah. I'm pleased. Besides that. All right, I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you later.